Is the doctor actually half human? Yes, he is. This doctor, specifically. The clone that was born from the DNA metacrisis with Donna. But what about our doctor? Well, kind of. Stick around and I'll explain how. And make sure to drop a like on this video if you want to see me make more Doctor Who content in the future. So, the Doctor and his humanity. This whole problem originated in the Doctor Who movie, featuring the Eighth Doctor, Paul Mcgann, where it was explained that the Doctor is actually half Gallifreyan, and his mother was a human from Earth. This went largely ignored when the show was rebooted, and for good reason. It had never been hinted at before the movie, and it clashed with a lot of the well-accepted lore of the time. It was referenced very briefly during the 12th Doctor's era, but only once and only in passing. Ultimately, it's up to the viewer's opinion whether or not the Doctor has any human genetics. In my opinion, he is 100% FDA-approved, kosher, Time Lord. But he did come very close to being human. Just once. It was during his short time as the 10th Doctor. A very commonly accepted fan theory is that the Doctor's personality and appearance are influenced strongly by his subconscious thoughts at the time of regeneration. I have a whole video on that idea right here. In the instance of the 9th Doctor, when he was dying, he had just realized that he was in love with Rose. She took the heart of the TARDIS into herself and saved the Doctor along with all of humanity. He took the heart of the TARDIS back from her by sharing their first kiss. It was at this point that 9 died and 10 was born. 10 was born from the desire the Doctor had for Rose. So he became young and handsome. He was a goofy, fun romantic, and he had much more of an emotional range than any of the Doctors that had come before. He was a Time Lord's best approximation of the perfect human male. And that did the job pretty well. Despite their rocky start, as Rose struggled to deal with the regeneration, she soon fell in love with the Doctor in a much stronger fashion than she had previously. She was going to stay with him forever, and the Doctor was okay with that, because he loved her too. That, of course, leads us to Doomsday. The Doctor and Rose are torn apart. He can't stop it. There's nothing he can do to get back to her. All he can manage is a holographic call to her that lasts little more than a minute. And here, Rose finally professes her love. The Doctor, hesitant, prepares to do the same before the message is ended abruptly. This is the Doctor's Time Lord nature clashing with his human side. Did you ever stop to wonder why the Doctor waited so long? Why he drew out his "I love you" for such a long time? Obviously, it made the scene more dramatic, and I would say iconic as well, but there are actual character motivations behind the lingering here. When you stop to think about Time Lords, they're practically immortal. They live for hundreds to thousands of years during each individual regeneration. The single century lifespan of a human is little more than a blip on their radar. Because of this, Time Lords are naturally stoic. They are unemotional, creatures of logic and reason above all else. Even someone as detached and unavailable as the 1st, 7th, or 9th Doctors would be considered overly manic on Gallifrey. They need to be this way. Would you choose to marry someone you loved if they could only be with you for a single month? That's what makes the 10th Doctor so interesting. He's struggling against his Time Lord nature. His disposition is far more human than it should be, and so, when faced with the last chance to tell Rose that he loves her, he freezes up. Not because he doesn't love her, but because he knows he can't be with her. If he says those words out loud, he will be admitting to himself that he loved her, and to do that is to accept all the hurt that it will cause him in the future. So now, we have a very human Doctor who can't fulfill his human purpose. Rose is gone, he doesn't have anyone to love, and he's stuck with all the human emotions he isn't used to feeling. And that leads into his actions throughout the next two series. Martha Jones joins him as his companion, and she is incredible. Martha is studying to be a doctor herself, and proves herself to be just as brave, cunning, and reliable as Rose ever was. She even managed to travel the entire planet all on her own, evading the forces of the Master and spreading stories of the Doctor. And during her journeys in the TARDIS, she fell in love with the Doctor too. But here's the trouble. The doctor had never dealt with human emotions before. He was never seriously romantically invested in a human before. So when he's faced with a rebound as great as Martha, of course he just ruins it. He's new to these emotions and inexperienced in romance. He's going to act just like a teenager, because he basically is one. Obviously, he still has his incredible scientific intellect, but emotional intelligence is something the doctor never was very well versed in. So he does exactly what a heartbroken teenager would do. Lead someone on in an attempt to chase the feeling of his previous flame. Martha eventually realizes this and decides to leave. It's mostly amicable, but this helps the doctor realize something. He can't get back what he lost with Rose, not with anybody other than Rose. So instead of playing make-believe in the world of romance, he indulges his pain, his darker emotions. Luckily, he is saved by a friend. Enter Donna Noble. Donna helps Ten break out of his funk. She causes him to move on emotionally, at least to the point where he doesn't try to recreate his time with Rose anymore. Donna was like a lifeline, a stabilizer for the doctor to take advantage of so he could build himself back up. And in return, the doctor changed Donna as well. She became kinder, more self-assured, less abrasive, and obsessed with petty things. The two were a shining example of the best of humanity. They made each other better people. Everything came to a head, however, when Davros stole the Earth. As events unfolded that led to the creation of the Dr. Donna, and subsequently the Metacrisis Doctor, who I will be calling 10-2, the stable life the Doctor had built for himself came crashing to the ground. Donna was ripped away from him as he was forced to wipe her memory in order to save her life. Rose returned, only briefly, before having to go back to her own dimension. And one thing I always wondered was, why did 10-2 go to be with Rose, while the original stayed here? Yes, he would only live the lifespan of a normal human, but surely there would have been at least a discussion about it between the two of them. But no, the doctor automatically abdicates the position to 10-2. Why? Because he knows what human emotion feels like, and he wouldn't dare hand over a life without Rose to someone even more human than himself. And this is more than evident in how they talk to Rose. The doctor still can't muster the courage to tell her how he feels. But 10-2, he's human. He has no Time Lord disposition to struggle against. He tells her that he loves her, and the two embrace. And now that the doctor is all alone, he experiences the lowest lows of his human emotions. He gets angry, very angry, with how the universe functions against his wishes, and he goes too far. He throws a tantrum. He changes a fixed point in time. Upon realizing the gravity of his mistake, he gets depressed. He can't stop those around him from dying, and he can't stop his own death, which he knows is coming for him. So he avoids it. He procrastinates, traveling through time, partying, indulging in empty romances. It's all to prolong the life he knows is ending soon. It's all to avoid the four knocks. And when those four knocks finally come, and the doctor accepts his fate, he does one last human thing. He rages. He shouts, he gets violent, and he loudly laments how his fate simply isn't fair. Completely gone is the stoic acceptance of the previous doctors. Ten is letting out all of his very human emotion before finally saying goodbye. What I find really fascinating is that the doctors who succeeded 10 weren't any less human. 11 and 12 had their far more alien moments and otherworldly attributes, but they both managed to reach the same emotional depths as 10. For whatever reason, experiencing human emotion was something that the doctor just couldn't let go of, even across lifetimes. The old adage must really be true. It's better to have loved and lost than never to have loved at all. We know that Ten agrees, because despite all the pain he felt during his time as the Doctor, all he has to say at the end is,
I don't want to go.
And those are my thoughts on why the Tenth Doctor is the most human. Who was your favorite of the Tenth Doctor's companions? Rose, Martha, or Donna? Let me know down in those comments. Be sure to subscribe, ring that bell, and consider supporting me on Patreon. And until next time, don't forget, Stay frosty.